lot of the young people started to use Mercury, but especially in the past 3 years, the increasing number of the senior users are starting to use Mercury. So the importance that to work on this research field has been growing, I think. Hi, this is Al from Al4D. Today we'd like to introduce our HCI research, which is a human-computer interaction. We work on the research and development at Al4D together with Bektour.
And today we'll speak on behalf of Hamada-san and Misato-san.
Let me briefly introduce about HCI in simple terms. So human-computer interaction refers to the interface between human and the computers. And the scope of HCI is quite broad. So Bektour, why do we work on the HCI research in Mercury?
As we just mentioned, human-computer interaction is kind of a wide field of research, but basically it deals with anything that involves the interfaces, the way that you interact with the content, with the data, or with other people. And here at Mercari, our main goal is to basically provide a better user experience, first of all, but also to look into how we can merge our work with other technologies, how we can do cross-disciplinary research. And our main goal here is to build a better user experience for Mercari users, and also to help us by creating a better user experience to help us create a wider user base. And at the same time, we're also looking into how we can expand our product and services by, for instance, engaging with different forms of research, technologies, media, or interactions.
And one of the characteristics we work on the HCI research is the Mercari app covers both the digital and the physical space. So the how to design the interaction between the user interface and the human is a very specific topic of what you are interested in. And additionally, the user base of Mercari services has been increasing in this few years because at the beginning, a lot of the young people started to use Mercari, but especially in the past 3 years, the increasing number of the senior users are starting to use Mercari. So the importance that to work on this research field has been growing, I think.
Yeah, especially as you mentioned, it's a big problem in Japan, which is called a super aging society. Mm-hmm. And I guess all products and services in Japan are kind of trying to acknowledge this issue. And this is also one of the targets that we're trying to track and cover within our HCI research at Mercari.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about what kind of situation we can make use of HCI research. Mm-hmm. So I think HCI research is utilized for many kinds of the situation, not only for senior users. There are many existing research projects to make the user interface or the user's experience more better and better. So Bektour, can you introduce the existing HCI research to encourage e-commerce shopping, for example?
When it comes to e-commerce shopping, actually HCI research is, there is a lot of interest, but it's kind of a emerging area of research, I would say, because there's still a lot of work being done in this area. And for instance, as we talked before, the aging population and accessibility are big problems. So for instance, currently a lot of e-commerce markets are trying to encourage users to use their websites or applications, but they're not always accessible, or they're not always available for common accessibility tools such as screen readers. So for instance, this is one of the interaction and interface problems where people with certain disabilities cannot use e-commerce applications, and this is something that we looked into.
So recently, I saw the one research project. They use the AR or VR for low vision people to assist the visual information. So for example, when the kind of user walking around the city, sometimes it's difficult to distinguish the border of the stairs and the flat ground. In that kind of situation, they can assist the visual information by the immersive interaction devices such as AR or VR.
Yeah, I agree. This is actually one of the most exciting emerging areas of augmented or virtual reality research, especially because as this technology is becoming more common, more widespread, it's available on almost any phone. The latest iPhone can even do like the 3D scanning using LiDAR. So, but the problem with, for instance, augmented or virtual reality as a medium is that it's primarily a visual medium. So, for instance, if you some kind of vision disabilities, you cannot use it. And by making this kind of environments more accessible and more available to users, I think this is something that we'll see more of in the nearest future. There's been a lot of work being done in this area.
And not only visual information, the existing devices are to rely on the screen interface, I think. So from the perspective, some research projects are working on the multimodal interaction. Multimodal interaction means that we do not rely on the only one sense to receive the information, which means that the current device, we focusing on the visual information on the screen, but in the next future, we might use both the sight and the hearing, or sometimes we may use the gesture and face recognition, or gesture and the haptics, or the kind of. So I think the kind of the multimodal interaction is one of the interesting research topic in this area.
Yep, I agree.
By the way, why did you decide to work on the HCI research in your career?
That's a good question, actually. I started as an augmented virtual reality developer. I started as a mobile developer, but then I did a lot of AR/VR research during my master's and PhD. And human-computer interaction was one of the areas that actually interested me because I was more interested on the, I guess, the experiential or the interactive part of my application rather than the technical issues. Human-computer interaction, in that case, is kind of, as we mentioned, it's a wide area. It encompasses a lot of different ideas. And I just felt that it's kind of the right place for my research interests. And as an HCI researcher, I guess I'm more exploring different forms of interactions and interfaces that we can build for different situations. And especially I'm interested in the human aspect, for instance, how people are going to react to, for instance, certain applications or certain issues, how we can solve them and so on and so forth. And what about you? Why were you interested in HCI research?
In the university, I used to work on research to enhance the usability on access control of Wi-Fi and the IoT onboarding stuff. So because authentication and the authorization of the user and the devices, the people tend to focus in on the security and the privacy area so much. Of course, it's very important, but sometimes the people are lacking on the perspective from the usability side. So that's why my interest in has been growing on the like the interface or usability stuff. So yeah, that's why I decided to work in on this team. And from my personal experiences, grandmother of my cousin, she is almost 90 years old, recently started to use smartphone. What surprised me was she doesn't use the web browser anymore. She decided to use YouTube to search content because maybe the video content or audio feedback, it's easy for her to access the information and to understand the recent content. So that also makes me very excited about this human-computer interaction area.
Interesting.
So today's video is about what is HCI research. So in the next video, we will dive into more deep HCI research. So what is cutting edge of the research project in the community right now, and what kind of research our team working on.
Thank you for watching, we'll hope to see you next time. Please give us a like button, subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you.